I'm glad to see so many of you here today to join in this special day for us, especially considering, as Scott said, how far quite a lot of you have come from it. America, Canada, South Africa, France, Japan up back. And of course, Scott has made it here today from Bonnyrigg, people. Ever since this wedding's been announced, there's only one thing that's ever played on my mind, and that is the first dance. Now, for many of you, you will know, some of you may not, Scott, he doesn't like dancing. No. One might say hates dancing. Yeah. So he can probably confirm this. He's not a big dancer, and through his entire 26 years, however old you are, he's only ever been able to do one dance. And as Michael's going to demonstrate, it's the mosh. As they say, all eyes on Scott for the first dance.
Well, as Scott mentioned, I've known him for a very long time. It's funny, you know, there's two best men. That's not normal, really, for a speech. And considering you had a choice of two people, it doesn't say much for your pool of friends when you chose up. But anyway, no, I've known Scott for a really long time, and I know he's been dreading this speech because he's quite shy. And it's probably why he suggested we do something other than give a speech. He wanted to get rid of all speeches, basically. He suggested we do mime, which was which was interesting. Interesting suggestion. Wouldn't really have worked though. And we dug up way too much fun stuff to pass up. Really. We spoke to some of his school friends, university friends. We've got lots of really fun stories, which we'd love to share with you right now. So we made a list of some of the more interesting things that Scott's got up to over his years. And Paul, you have the list right here. So,
stop.
Enjoy. What's this? This is not the list. No?
No.
Scott, you sly sob you. It looks like Scott has taken out super injunction against our speech. So we're not allowed to mention anything about the high heels.
You're not my brother anymore, you know that.
Sorry, I meant to ask tomorrow though.
Follow me on Twitter, I'm sure you'll all find out exactly what happened. That really only leaves one thing left for us to do, you see, and that's give our version of how Scott and Zoe managed to meet. And I tell you, it's a pretty interesting story. One might even say, it's quite creepy.
just amazed Scott isn't gay.